My dear students, now I am continuing the module 2, process of manufacturing of concrete. As we know, concrete is made up with cement, sand, aggregate and water. Here we are just considering the fresh concrete. So the difference between the fresh concrete and the hardened concrete is, in the fresh concrete it should be in a plastic sheet like we can see in a picture. In the picture we can see this is called as a fresh concrete. Hardened concrete is nothing but after placing and compacting, finally the shape of the concrete can be called as an hardened concrete. I will share the notes after this video lecturing. You can go through it. The process of manufacturing of concrete. So in first one, the manufacturing of concrete, there are various steps, like first one, batching, mixing, transporting and placing, compacting, curing and finishing. The first process is batching. What do you mean by batching? In this step, just we are separating the particles. That is called as an batching. As we know, differentiating the girls and boys in a classrooms like that, or we are separating the particles or ingredients of the concrete. Those are the ingredients, nothing but making a separate cement, sand and aggregate. Next, the second step is mixing. In this mixing, we are, as the name indicates, mixing the cement, sand and constituent materials. And the third one is transportation. Transportation is nothing but, we have already seen in a RMC trips, because the site will be at one location and the RMC plant will be at the different location. While coming from one place to another place, there is a mixture is required, that is known as in transportation. Placing from one place to another place is known as a transportation. This is the third step. And the fourth one, placing. After the transportation, we can see in the picture, this is nothing but a placing of concrete. A man is placing concrete onto a RCC elements. You can see this clearly, this is nothing but a slab. Just he is placing the concrete. After this placing, next step is compacting. Because of the voids presented in the concrete, there may be air voids or maybe a water voids, maybe anything. To avoid the voids, we need to compact the concrete with the help of, again, there are different steps like vibrators or hand compacting or machine compacting. You can go for any types of compacting. After the compacting, the next important method is curing. Why the important method is because in this state only the concrete is getting complete strength. If you wanted to reduce the concrete strength or if you wanted to increase the concrete strength, depends on the complete step, is nothing but curing. If we do the proper curing, the concrete will be get automatically good strength. If we avoid the curing, automatically the concrete will be at a lesser strength. And the last one is finishing, because in this step the finishing of concrete should be done. As we know, because of the aesthetic view of the concrete properties, it should be a good condition. To get an aesthetic view, good condition, we need to go for the finishing. So let us go through one by one. First one is batching. Batching means nothing, separation of particles. Second one, mixing. Third one, transporting. Fourth one, placing and compacting, curing and finishing. Let us see one by one. In batching, again there are different categories. In batching there are two categories. One is volume batching and another one is weight batching. As the name indicates, volume batching, with the help of this type of bucket, we are separating the particles with respect to the one bucket, two bucket, three bucket, like this. Here we are not considering any weight of the material, just we are taking the volume of the material. But this type of volume batching is not appropriate or good. As we know, sand and aggregates, if it is subjected to water, the volume has been increased or decreased. It is dependent on the water quantity presented in the aggregates. The moisture content present in the aggregates, that may lead to the different volume changes. So that volume may be affects on the strength of concrete. So as we know, here it is clearly mentioned that the volume batching is not a good method. The first step only they have given. Next, second one, this table I have taken from the MHRT textbook. You can go through that. The table number 6.3, volume of various gauge boxes. The width of the gauge box is 33.3 and the height is 30, depth is 20. The volume of the liter in terms of liter will be 20 liter. Quantity here taken 1. Item number is A. For example, you can take a cement. Cement is taken in a 1 quantity of bucket. And second item, sand. You can go for a fine aggregate. Third one will be coarse aggregate. And the last one, maybe you can go for admixture or anything. Here we can see that quantity numbers. Nothing but how many buckets you have taken. As we already discussed, this one is the most neglecting method. As we know, we are civil engineers, we need to go for a accuracy. So we are preferring the second batching, nothing but weight batching. In some cases, if you are not getting any weights, in such cases we can go for the volume batching. But most of the cases we need to go for the weight batching only. Second one, weight batching. This method is an exact method or correct method of measuring of aggregates, because with the help of weighing balance, directly we can measure how much quantity of an aggregates taken, how much quantity of water has been added, how much quantity of cement has been taken. Because we know cement bag of the weight is 50 kg. One bag of cement is nothing but 50 kg. Next, in weight batching, there are the different equipments which have been used for the construction. You can go one by one. Weigh batching. These are the, in the examination you are not supposed to draw these diagrams, just you know the names of the equipments. But in the volume batching you should draw this figure, because here it is mentioned length, breadth, depth and height of the volume. Now these are the equipments used for the weight batching. Next one is mixing. As we know, in the mixing steps, again there are two methods. One is hand mixing and second one is machine mixing. As hand mixing, we can see in the figure here only, many of the practical cases will go for the hand mixing. Hand mixing is suitable only when the quantity of the concrete is very less. In case of the large sites, in case of the requirement of more quantity of concretes, this hand mixing is not suitable, because while mixing the concrete, there may be evaporation of water, there may be a segregation in the aggregates, there may be a bleeding in the aggregates. So